In this video, I'm going to show you two quick methods for cleaning out a 3D printer nozzle. One can be done with the nozzle still attached to your printer, and the other one is with your nozzle removed. There are a few different reasons why you might want to clean your nozzle, but a clog or a partial clog are the most common. You may simply want to completely remove one colour of filament before starting with another colour and not want to completely push it all through the nozzle. Either way, these methods will help you clean the nozzle. The first method is known as a cold pull, or sometimes called an atomic pull. This method works best with lined hot ends like you'll find on a lot of beginner printers like the Ender 3 version 2 that I'll be demonstrating with today. A cold pull is possible on an all-metal hot end, but it can be a bit trickier and you may need to mess around with temperatures a bit to suit your printer. The basic idea of a cold pull is to pull the filament back away from the nozzle when the filament is soft but not as runny as it would be when it's extruded while you're printing. Some people would say that this method works better with the hotter printing filaments like PETG, ABS and nylon, but I use it with PLA and have no problems. You'll need to have filament loaded and know that your nozzle is full of filament. The easiest way to do this is to extrude a little bit first. Then change your nozzle temperature down to 90 degrees C and watch on the display as it drops. When the temperature hits 90 degrees, pull the filament straight out. You may find a bit of resistance, but if you pull a bit harder, it should come out. If not, then increase your nozzle temperature gradually until it does pull out. This is what you should see at the end of your filament. This is the plug of filament that was inside your nozzle completely removed and leaving it clean. If you have any filament on the outside of the nozzle, then you need to wipe it off when the nozzle is up to full temperature. If you're enjoying this video, then let me know by hitting like. If you want to see more of this kind of thing, then hit subscribe too. I make regular videos to help you with 3D printing and other projects. The second method for cleaning your nozzle is a little bit more involved, and it's a method that I use when I have filament on the threads. It's not a good idea to screw in a nozzle that has filament all over the threads, as it can lead to stripped threads in your heat block. Some people will tell you to heat your nozzle up with a blowtorch or a heat gun. While this method can work, it's not a very controlled way of heating up your nozzle. We want our nozzles to keep their close tolerances, and extreme heat can cause damage. If you have a hardened steel nozzle, then overheating will actually change the temper and remove those hard-wearing properties that we want these nozzles for. Instead, I find that a soldering iron is a much more controlled way of heating your nozzles without causing any damage. A soldering iron on its own can get to about 300 degrees centigrade, and with the nozzle sitting on the end, it only gets up to about 270, which is perfect for cleaning out filament. I filed down an old tip so it fits inside the back of a nozzle. This way the nozzle will sit on the top while it's heating. And also make sure you remove any solder at all from the tip. The last thing you want to do is leave solder inside your nozzle. With your soldering iron up to temperature and held securely, using a glove or some pliers, push your nozzle onto the end. Now it's just a case of leaving your nozzle to heat up gently, and any excess filament will bubble out of the tip. You can just wipe this away with an old rag. After the filament stops coming out, you can even use a brass brush to remove anything more stubborn. If you have a nozzle cleaning needle, then run it through the hole before removing your nozzle and placing it somewhere safe to cool down. Obviously the nozzle is now going to be hot, so don't go picking it up with anything other than a heat glove or pliers or something similar. Your nozzle is now clean and ready to reuse. If you want more 3D printing content, click here. Or click here for another video you might enjoy. Thanks for watching.